छोटा लेते हैं
ना पिना। Good morning all. So in previous video lecture in previous video lecture so we have analysis and synthesis of TV. So in that in previous video lecture you are familiar about gross picture, resolution, etc. So in this So in this slide we are watching analysis and synthesis of TV picture. So in that one, scanning. So scanning, what is the after gross picture? After gross picture, next parameter is scanning. So scanning is nothing but it is a process how this TV picture carried out in particular TV system. That is a similar process that is carried out in the TV system. So why? Because the scene is scanned rapidly both in horizontal and vertical directions. And simultaneously, it is able to provide sufficient number of complete pictures or frames per second to give the illusion of continuous motion. That's why here we are mentioning instead of 24. So instead of 24, that is a commercial motion picture. So here frame reception is 25%. Frame reception is 25% in most of the television picture. So instead of 24, so as in commercial, that is most of So most of the reception rate, most of the frame reception rate is 25 per second in most television pictures. That is the importance of scanning. So by doing this scanning, the frames are retrieved. So it is a similar process is carried out in TV, so that the scenes are rapidly both in horizontal and vertical directions. So simultaneously it is able to provide sufficient number of successful transmission. So that's why here again they mentioned the horizontal deflection. So it is a trace period. So it is a trace period, retrace period. So trace period plus retrace period equal to one cycle of deflection current. So trace period and retrace period. So trace period and retrace period, here we are taking as one cycle full deflection. So this is called retrace and trace. So therefore this picture frame has to retrieve 625 lines. So therefore raster period, these trace and retrace periods are very important. So trace period and retrace periods are very important and to calculate the one cycle of deflection. That is about horizontal scan. So you are familiar about how to do horizontal scan. So controversy here, vertical scan. So the vertical scan is, so by whom this vertical scan is initiated, that is simply called vertical deflection coil. So vertical deflection coils are responsible. So vertical deflection coils are responsible to provide the currents. So that are called vertical currents. So this sawtooth current in the vertical deflection coil moves from the electron beam top to bottom of the raster at a uniform speed while the electron beam is being deflected horizontally. So that is the principle for vertical scan. So thus beam produces complete horizontal lines below the other while moving from top to bottom. So in this horizontal scan, the beams are moving in horizontal direction. Whereas in vertical, the beam produces complete horizontal lines, one below the other while moving from the top to bottom. So this is the main methodology implemented in the particular criteria. So in the particular figure, so you are familiar about the particular figure. So see here. So what is the vertical deflection, and this deflection current waveforms are represented here. So this is the trace diagram. So it is the raster diagram, trace diagram. So this trace diagram can be implemented by like this one. So this is the top end and the bottom end. This is a trace and a retrace. So this is called a retrace. So vertical retrace. So if you are considering this is one frame. If you are considering this is one frame. So this is a top plane, vertical trace and retrace. So for a vertical trace and a retrace, we are taking a beam deflection. We are providing beam deflection. So that beam deflection here implemented. So therefore, the beam has deflected horizontally and vertically in both the directions. So for that one, so there is a vertical beam that will be here. See here, vertical beam. The trace part of sawtooth wave for vertical scan deflects the beam to the bottom of the raster. So this is the bottom of the raster. So top deflection brings the net field, brings the net field to the bottom plane. So due to that, what happens? Rapid vertical retrace returns the beam to the top. So maximum amplitudes of vertical sweep current brings the beam to the bottom of the raster. That is shown in here already. So due to this trace period and retrace period, so there is a net replica of forces that are exerted due to this one. So during the vertical retrace of horizontal scan, continuous and several lines get scanned during this period. So because of the motion in the scene being televised, the information or brightness at the top of the target plate or picture tube screen, so normally changes by time. So there are return to the top recursive whole process. So therefore, what is the main thing that we have to see in this one? The information is picked up during the next scan cycle. Therefore, whole process is repeated. Therefore, the approximately 25 times to cause an illusion of the continuity. So the actual scan sequences is, however, little more complex. Therefore, so the scan beams at the camera tube and picture tube are blanked. No picture information is either picked up or reproduced. So instead of doing this time division basis, So these short retrace intervals are utilized for transmitting a distinct narrow pulse to keep the sweep oscillator of the picture tube deflection circuit in the particular time chimera. So this ensures the perfect exact correspondence in the scan. At the two ends, the result distortionless reproduction of the picture details that should be available in the form of scan lines. So this due to this one, the scan beaming at the camera tube and picture tubes are blanked, and there is no picture information is either picked up or reproduced. So instead on time division basis, these short retrace time intervals are utilized for transmitting distinct narrow pulses to keep the picture oscillator tube deflections circuits of the particular receiver in the synchronization with this camera tube. So to retrieve all these scan lines perfectly, so generally the front panel of TV receiver has its own controls like brightness control, channel selection, volume control, picture tube selection. So these are various channel selectors which are used for selecting the desired channel. Is very important one. So the channel selectors which used to select the desired channel, so the fine tuning is control is able to provide the best picture that is selected by the channel. And hold button used to get the steady picture, whether if the picture moves up or down. Similarly, the brightness control varies the picture beam intensity, picture tube, and so that is set optimum value for a picture. So till that end, So due to this hold control button, the steady state picture that telecasted during the right end. So why? Because some television pictures, there is a problem for continuous rolling up and downs. So those problems are perfectly eliminated here. Those problems are perfectly eliminated here while you are using the hold control button. Similarly, while you are watching the TV broadcast, so automatically brightness control button is available. So that brightness control button helps to vary the intensity of telecast beam of the picture tube, and it is set for optimum average brightness of the picture. So why we are talking about these parameters are nothing but most of the television pictures has a very problem in particular television broadcasting. So that's why here we are most of scenes have brightness gradation in the vertical direction. So that is the ability. So that is the ability of scanning beam to allow that particular reproduction of electrical signals. So that are according to the variations and the capability of human eye to resolve these distinct pictures separately. So if it is possible, so if it is possible to arrive some estimation, so those number of lines necessary, so by considering these patterns where the alternating lines are be black and white, if the thickness of particular scan beams are equal to width of each white and black bar. So imagine the most of these scenes have their brightness gradation in the particular vertical direction. So the ability of this scan beam, the ability of this scan beam to allow particular reproduction of electrical signals. So according to variations, so that capability of human eye that can resolve this picture individually and separately. So obviously this greater number of lines into which where picture is divided in vertical plane, so that vertical plane resolution is greater. So the total number of lines that are needed and employed by its limited by resolving the capability of human eye, those which is having minimum viewing distance from a fixed object. So automatically your brightness should be increases. So this is the scan spot. So some example for beam formation. So some example for beam formation where our beam is exactly that is able to catch these beams which are separable, which are separately. So therefore approximately the beam formation depend upon the brightness, depend upon the brightness of the television picture. So if you suppose how this dimensions of this beam path is where it is nothing but if this beam spot moves scroll down from left to right, so automatically there is a beam path is generated likewise. Clear? So in this way your beam path is transmitting. So therefore in this direction, so automatically there is a huge change might be happens when beam path is traveling from left to right. So when this dark light, when this D for dark and W for white, so when the black and white, dark and white, so this is the pattern where white, so this is white, this is dark, and this is dark. So this is W. This is dark. So this is W. So like dark and white, multiple frames which are available on the TV raster. So therefore, due to beam spot mechanism, there is a scanning spot perfectly aligned with black and white lines. So this beam spot continuously touch the dark bar and white bar. So this is a white bar and a dark bottom bar. So dark and white bars perfect alignment is available here. So due to that, so here in this slide, so you are all watching the critical viewing distance that is determined by ability of eye to resolve two separate picture elements. So what is meant by two separate picture elements are nothing but here element equal to color. So white and black. So that critical distance viewing ability of the eye that are separated here by picture elements. So two adjacent black pictures elements just resolve. So that angle is obtained at the eye, the particular picture elements at a critical viewing angle. So the maximum number of alternate black and white lines which can be resolved by the eye, that can be defined by here formula that NV equal to 1 by divided by alpha P. So here L equal to, suppose if our screen has suppose let me say there are n the bar. Suppose already we mentioned in a particular TV system, in particular TV system, we are having suppose nth bar. So what is the next bar? So what is the next line? Simply called n plus 1. So that nth bar and n plus 1, that nth bar and n plus 1th bar is successful for transmission of this picture signals. So two adjacent black pictures elements are be resolved. So let's take W and H are the width and dimensions of particular TV raster screen. So the distance of viewing, the distance of critical viewing distance that is equal to 4 times of height. So you were already, we are mentioning width to height 4 by 3. So width to height equal to 4 by 3. So that H equal to 3, therefore D equal to 4 into 3, 12. Units are called units distance required between our eye of the particular observer and particular viewing distance. So that is angle subtended at the eye by that element at a critical viewing distance alpha. So that alpha is the critical viewing distance alpha. So that alpha might be seen here, that alpha. So that alpha can be might be seeing here. So that value equal to 1 by alpha p, that value equal to here 1 by alpha p, the maximum number of the line that dark elements that can be resolved due to the distance. So that will happens when the resolving from the die. So what is the requirement? What is the for the eye, the resolution is determined by the structure of the retina. So what is here by the structure of the particular retina. So for the eye, this resolution is determined by the structure of retina and the brightness level of the picture. And it has been determined experimentally that with reasonable brightness variations and a minimum viewing distance of 4 times of the picture, so that is d by h equal d h equal d equal to 4h. So the angle that any two adjacent elements must subtended at the eye for the distant resolution. So by this formula, NV equal to 1 divided by pi by 180 into 1 by 60 into 4, that equal to 860. So 1 by pi by 180 into 1 by 60 into 4, that equal to 860. So for that one, for the eye, this is the resolution determined by the structure of the retina and the brightness level. That brightness level, brightness level of the picture. So it has been determined experimentally that with the reasonable brightness variations and a minimum viewing distance that equal to d equal to 4h. So that you are having 860. So that is the resolution approximately equal to 1 minute. So think how much bigger resolutions are generated. So thus, if total number of these scan lines are chosen, so there may be 860 in the previous answer. So these are the number of scan lines, 860. And the scanning beam is explained that it passes over each bar separately while scanning all the lines from top to bottom of the picture. Set a particular distinct.
हेलो उसको ये लेकर
3 बाव का था। हाँ ओके हाँ चल So thus, if the total number of scan lines are chosen, which are very close to 860, so the scan beam that are passes over which separately while scanning all these lines from top to bottom of a picture frame. So at a distance pick up by this picture information, so the results and this is best that can expected from the system.
So this perhaps explains the total number 819. So therefore our regular normal foreign country. So in practice, however, picture elements are not arranged as equally spaced segments, but have random distributions of black, gray, white. So depending on nature of the picture, details are seen under the particular considerations. So this is the statistical environment, the statistical environment that should generally requires the condition. So next slide, the statistical analysis that are subjective tests carried out to determine the average. The statistical analysis and subjective tests carried out to determine the average number of effective lines. So there is about 70% of the total lines that are segments separately scanned the vertical direction. So the remaining 30% can merged with other elements due to the beam spot falling equally on the consecutive lines. So this is the nature where your beam spot, so adjacent black and white lines of the particular resolutions are generated here. So this is the effective number of lines, that is effective number of lines resolved. So the formula equal to our number of lines, vertical scan lines that equal in previous 860 here. So 860 multiplied by scanning period, that is a resolution factor. So that is happening with the effective number of lines. So number of effective lines, so clear? Number of effective lines equal to, this is the formula. So number of vertical factor, that is 860 multiplied by resolution factor. So resolution factor for televisions 0.65 to 0.75. So what is the answer? We are getting 860 multiplied by 0.7. So you are having 602. So here NR equal to NV multiplied by K. So that is the majority of the scenes, that is majority of the scenes that are transmitted here. So however, there are a number of, there are other factors. So there are other factors which are influencing the choice of total number of lines in the particular TV. So why? Because our eye can detect the effective sharpness, brightness, contrast through this 800 scanning lines. So, but the improvement is not very significant with the lines. So greater extent, so 500 lines. So viewing pictures having the motion. So however, number of lines having this motion picture. So there are a total number of lines in the particular television, so the TV system. So there is a test conducted, so 800 scanning lines. So already we said, mentioned that channel bandwidth. If the bandwidth increases, parallelly number of lines increases. So when number of lines are increases, when the number of lines are increases, so automatically it will affect on the transmission band. So number of channels, number of television channels that can be provided and given VHF or UHF transmission band. So the channel bandwidth increases. If the channel bandwidth increases, there increases the number of lines. So therefore, total bandwidth should be affected. So this is about importance of scan lines, how we are able to achieve the scan lines. Clear? So total scan lines, scanning is very important. The televised scenes are scanned rapidly, both in horizontal and vertical directions simultaneously. So in our broadcast standards 24, picture frames, that is a frame reception rates 24 per second. 24 per second is the frame receptions. So that scan, horizontal scan, so this slide has horizontal scan explanation. This is the representation of horizontal scanning procedure. Vertical scan, what is the importance of vertical scan? And what is the methodology implemented in vertical scan? So this is the justification in between horizontal and vertical scan, how we are viewing the pictures with more. This is the way that is the scanning spot, black and white. So this is the formula where you can build. It is 1 by alpha over rho, where alpha equal to angle subtended at the eye by picture element at critical viewing distance. So this is very important formula, NV equal to 860. Key points are like this one. Now we move on to next subtopic, very short answer question, flicker. So generally flickers are observed in olden TVs, but now majority of TVs are LED and LCD options. These flickers are now due to broadcasting standards, digitalization. So flicker problem is overcoming present era. So the rate of that is picture rate, 24 pictures per second in motion pictures, and scannings are 25 frames per second. So in the particular TV pictures is enough to cause an illusion of continuity. They are not rapid enough to allow the brightness of one picture or frame to blend smoothly into the next through the time when the scene is blanked between successive frames. So this problem will called some illusion problem when the during trace and retrace. This is the problem generally noticed when trace and retraces are perfectly in the broadcasting. So that's why called a flicker of light, very annoying to the observer when the scene is made alternatively bright and dark. So this is the definition. This is the definition for flicker, where the televised picture feels some annoying to the observer. So this problem can be solved in motion picture by making the count is greater. So 48 shown per second. So there are still same 24 picture frames second. So this will problem. So what is the remedy? What is the remedy to removing? What is the remedy for this flicker? Is nothing but simple, just to increase picture per second count for 24 to double 48. So as a result of this one, the blanking rate is increases automatically, flicker perfectly eliminated in TV scene. Very important short answer, define flicker. So define flicker. So what is the meaning for flicker equal to the frames due to the low frame rate, brightness of one picture or frame is able to blend smoothly into the next through the time when the screen will become as blanked between the successive frames. So this problem is termed as flicker in TV engineering. It should be able to remove when you can increase the count of pictures per second 24 to 48. So on the same line, continuation for flicker, we have interlaced scanning. So scanning in the previous task, horizontal and vertical. So continuation line by line. So whereas in interlaced scan, the scan will be done alternative lines. So in TV picture, the 50 vertical scans per second is utilized to reduce the pixel. So in the frames 48. Now you can increase the number of scans or 50 to reduce this flicker. So this is accomplished by increasing the down rate. This is accomplished by increasing the down rate of scanning electron beam, so that every alternating lines gets scanned instead of every successive lines. So then when the beam reaches the bottom of the picture frame, it quickly returns to the top scan. Those lines were missed in previous scan. Suppose in the continuous scan, the problem observed by the experts, some elements may be lost their perceiveness or getting the information by this electron beam. So that is the main problem noticed during horizontal and vertical scan. So that horizontal and vertical scan problem, in that problem perfectly eliminated by interlaced scan. So in that interlaced scan, when the beam reaches the bottom of the picture frame, quickly it returns to top of scan. Those things are missed in the previous scan. So there is no mismatching occurs between this. So this total number of lines we are having, this is the picture. This is a very important picture for principle of interlaced scan. So principle of interlaced scan. So vertical retrace is able to assume it to be zero. This is the beginning of first field. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 625, even and odd. So first field partition, two fields, first field, second field. So 313 lines first field, 314 to 625 later in previous scene. the total number of lines divided into two groups called fields. Each field is scanned alternatively. That is the main basic principle of interlaced scan. It will automatically reduces the previous problem flicker. So that is acceptable level since the area of screen is covered at twice particular rate. So this is the reading alternating lines of the page from top to bottom once. So and going back to read the particular lines to the down area.